Let me toss that to Prasanna. You know, you and Ashish, Prasanna, don't have the luxury of not guessing a stance. So if you have to guess what they would do next, do you see seeds of another hike there?
So I think, Lata, to start with, I'll have to, I think, accept what Mrithu Sagar just said. I think we are in a situation where data dependency is going to be key. And if you really look at the first year after COVID, it was clearly rates were going down, and then the second year rates were clearly going up because of inflation. But you reached a situation where data could go either way, and we have reached a level of rates which is substantially, you know, on the higher side. So it's difficult either way. So having said all this, I think RBI chose this path because of the fact that the Fed is, it's also not very clear where the Fed is going to stop. So I think having all cards close to their chest is a good strategy for them. And like you rightly said, if we have to, you know, kind of take into account what kind of stance it is going to be going forward, I would again say that I think it's a kind of a 50-50 kind of a thing. While earlier, before the policy, I was thinking that this would be the last rate hike, and I was reasonably confident on that prognosis. But now when I, you know, the especially the data which has come out of the US just last Friday, the jobs data, and, you know, the very possibility of the Fed hiking well into the Fed rate of 5.25, and the RBI keeping all cards close to his chest, not wanting to indicate where they are headed or where the peak is. And the fact that the narrow interest rate differential means that the rupee at the margin will be at having a pressure. So from all that perspective, I think you can't discount another rate hike. So if the Fed were to go to five to five quarter kind of a range, which means two hikes in the next two policies, it's very much possible that there might be another hike, but it's a 50-50 kind of a thing.
Prasanna, a similar question to you. I mean, are you also not that terribly worried about, you know, insurance companies not coming and doing forward rate agreements with you, asking you to warehouse bonds for them? Secondly, this borrowing lending mechanism, the press conference, it became very clear it was intended for insurance companies. It will be in the CCIL. Will that have a bearing on the yield curve?
So I'll try to answer it very quickly since Ashish has given a detailed reply, Lata. I think I would be slightly worried about the borrowing program, but not just because of, you know, insurance companies potentially not coming to the extent they came. It's also because of the fact that when we are comparing gross borrowing and net borrowing, we are comparing it with this year and the next year, and then we are saying that there's a nominal GDP growth, so the entire economy is growing. However, you have to note that the beginning of the year, we had a huge surplus liquidity in the banking system, and that liquidity is now down almost to zero, maybe give or take a few lakhs of crores. So from that perspective, I think the banking system is going to operate in a liquidity neutral, marginal liquidity surplus kind of an environment. So to that extent, the marginal propensity to buy government bonds is going to be that much lesser. Second, more important thing is also that I would have probably assume that if the peak to the rate hike cycle is very, very close, then maybe to some extent borrowing can go through much more easily. But after having seen what's happened today, where all the cards are now close to RBI's chest, it's quite possible that there is a little bit of uncertainty with respect to what's going to happen to short-end rates. So if short-end rates are also going to be under pressure because of the potential, you know, potential, let's say, one more rate hike, then it's quite possible that the rest of the yield curve can also, you know, kind of drag up. And also remember that the SDL supply is going to be higher. All this can be compensated by, you know, a global bond index inclusion, which unfortunately doesn't look like a real possibility at this point of time, maybe. Okay. Or could, in the second half of the year, open market operations might be required by the Reserve Bank of India.
Okay. Can I have a rapid fire? All of you, please tell me, what do you expect in the April policy? Hike or pause? Prasanna first.
Pause, Lata, but I can't rule out at 25.
No. One word. Pause. Very quickly, only for the bankers. Prasanna, what is the likely range? Any depreciation or appreciation?
So I think, Lata, it will be a depreciating bias. But of course, a lot depends upon when the Fed peaks. When the Fed peaks, you will see a dollar weakening. So INR can benefit at that time, but not immediately.